Good afternoon, I'm Alessia Porticarini and I'm a doctoral student at the University of Camerino. Today I'm going to present a simple mathematical model that is able to predict the final concentration of the chemical substances extracted during the percolation of the espresso coffee. This work is carried out by Dr. Josephine Giacomini, Professor Pierluigi Maponi and me. The coffee market is of great relevance in the global economy. In fact, coffee after natural gas is the most exported raw material as well as one of the most consumed beverages in the world. The fame of coffee beverage is due to its unmistakable flavor originating from over 1,000 compounds contained in coffee. The success of coffee poses a new challenge for the environmental sustainability of the coffee industry. Reduce the pressure to agriculture and forestry sector below the equatorial zone. In other words, the raw material used in the preparation phase has to be minimized. Moreover, in order to increase the customer satisfaction, the quality and reproducibility of the beverage should be kept high. The percolation process of espresso coffee consists in pressurized hot water that enters the filter basket filled with roasted ground coffee and flows through the empty spaces between the grain of coffee powder. During this process, known as percolation, the water dissolves the chemical substances contained in the coffee powder by two main steps. The imbibition, where the hot water leaks into the single grain, and the extraction, where the pressurized hot water transports the dissolved substances from the grains to the coffee cup. The extraction by pressurized hot water is obtained by high pressure imposed at the top surface of coffee pod that allows the water to go against the resistance of the compact porous medium. We present a mathematical model to formulate the dissolution process and in turn to simulate the espresso coffee percolation. In the espresso coffee extraction, we have to take into account the two physical phases involved, namely liquid and solid phase, and the main physical phenomena occurring for each of them. In particular, the advective transport and the diffusion for species in the liquid phase and the diffusion process of the substances through the grains in the solid phase. In this process, the grains dimension play an important role. The figure shows a typical granulometric curve of coffee powder. As you can see, it has a bimodal trend. So, coffee grain are approximated by spheres with two distinct radii for fine and coarse grains, usually called fines and boulders respectively. In fact, the grains dimensions affect the extraction for two key reasons: the porosity, since fines and boulders create the porous medium and their portion affect the structure of the medium, and the dissolution rate, since the grain size determines the distance and therefore the time for which the chemical substances must undergo the diffusive transport process within the grains before getting to the surface. In order to predict the final concentration of the substances extracted during the percolation process, we have to simulate the dissolution process for each chemical substances that we want to trace. Moreover, since we suppose that species don't affect each other, we only discuss one. The initial boundary value problem describes the dynamics of the liquid phase of a chemical substance during the process. So, we have one problem of this type for each chemical substance that we have to predict. We denote with Cl the concentration of the liquid chemical substance outside the grain that has been dissolved and it is being transported by the water flow. The first equation of the problem is an advection diffusion reaction equation, and its right-hand side consists of a diffusive term, an advective term, and two reactive terms as sources. Such source terms give the relation between the concentrations of liquid and solid species. The second and third equation are the boundary condition at the inlet and at the outlet of the coffee pod. In particular, no flux of soluble across the inlet is allowed, while at the outlet no diffusive flux is prescribed. Finally, the initial condition is given. The extraction model is completed with the dynamics of the solid phase within the grains, which is modeled by the following initial band arrival problem. We denote with CF and CB the concentration in final molders respectively of the coffee chemical substances contained in the grains and not yet involved in the transport process outside the grain. So, the problem is prescribed for fines and for boulders. We observe that, for each zeta level, where a liquid concentration is given by the previous problem, there are two problems for the solid concentration corresponding to the zeta level. Therefore, we have two problems of this type for each chemical substance we have to predict. The first equation of the problem is the diffusion equation in spherical coordinates in the case of spherical symmetry. It describes the transport of chemicals within the coffee grains, while the second and third equation are the boundary condition and the last one is the initial condition. In particular, the third equation describes the mass transfer occurring between the chemical extracted from the grains and the liquid flow moving among the grains. Such exchange is described by the reaction term GE, that gives the flux per unit area of chemicals through the interface between the grains and the waste spaces among them. In the slide is reported the formulation we used for the reaction term. So, the flux is zero when the liquid immediately near the grains is saturated or it is at the same concentration of the dissolved substances at the grain surface, or when all solubles inside the grain have been dissolved. In conclusion, the complete mathematical model consists of the previous two coupled problems for each chemical substance to be monitored. The numerical approximation is performed applying the Crank-Nicolson method together with the first-order Hopkins scheme for the spatial discretization of the advective term. The discretized system is reported in the slide in matrix form. The matrix A and C are suitable diagonal block matrices where each block is tridiagonal. B and D are suitable tridiagonal matrices. All these matrices contain the discretization coefficient. CF and CB and CL are the time-space discretized counterparties of the solid and liquid concentration respectively. In particular, the first component of CFB are related to the fine solid concentration, while the last ones are related to the boulder solid concentration. CFB and CL are the known vector. Also, FFB is organized as CFB. Moreover, capital FFB and capital FL are the vector of the nonlinear terms. The previous system can be written as in the slide, where sigma corresponds to the solid concentration, lambda to the liquid concentration, phi to the nonlinear term of the solid dynamics, and psi to the nonlinear term of the liquid dynamics. The solution of the system is based on a two-step procedure. For each time step, we consider a nested fixed point iteration, which consists in solving consecutively the linear system of each row for a given n. In particular, the index nu stands for the inner fixed point iteration, while mu for the outer. In more details, the inner iteration is reported in the slide for the fixed mu equal to 1. It consists in solving the reported linear system with suitable guesses and applying the stopping criterion in the slide. Then, we repeat this procedure also for the linear system in the second row, similarly. The outer iteration consists in repeating the previous steps with the initial guesses obtained with the inner iteration and proper stopping criteria. The model validity is demonstrated on an experimental basis. First of all, the discretized system were implemented in a MATLAB program in order to obtain the so-called in silico coffee, that is, the numerical simulation of the extraction. Then, we came out an extraction campaign in which we collected several espresso samples under different conditions of water pressure, water temperature, and granulometry of the coffee powder. Then, the extracted samples were analyzed, and the results of the chemical analysis were compared with the results of the numerical simulation. The extractive campaign was performed using a pure Arabica coffee. We kept constant the mass of dry coffee used, and also the mass of extracted coffee beverages kept constant. In the slide is reported the parameter configuration tested. These parameters are the standard parameters adopted by barista in the coffee brewing. The substances we decide to monitor in the preliminary test are between the most relevant in affecting the coffee beverage taste. And they are the caffeine, the total amount of chlorogenic acids, the citric acid, and the lipids. The figure of this and next slide show the comparison between the numerical and experimental results for the tested substances, where the granulometry varies along the x-axis. The black vertical bars are the range identified from the chemical analysis. The horizontal bars are the expected value calculated from the experimental data, while the circle markers are the results of the numerical simulation. The left figure in the slide shows the comparison for the caffeine. The comparison shows a good agreement between numerical and experimental results. In fact, the simulated caffeine values for fine and optimal granulometry fall in the range identified by experimental data, while for the coarse granulometry there is an underestimation less than the 2%. While the right figure shows the comparison for the chlorogenic acids. For this substance, the results are even better. In fact, all the simulated values fall in the range identified by the experimental data. Also for the citric acid in the right figure, the results are very good, while the lipids in the left are the hardest substance to predict. In fact, only the optimal granulometry falls in the range of the experimental data, while for the fine granulometry they are overestimated of about the 3% and for the coarse granulometry they are underestimated of about the 5%. In conclusion, we presented a simple model for the analysis and control of the extraction process. The comparison between the experimental and numerical results of the preliminary test show its good predictive power. The model has been discretized with an efficient method, so once analyzed the solving strategy critical issues in order to refine it, this simulation tool can be integrated into professional machines in order to increase the sustainability of the coffee industry and the customer's satisfaction as well. Furthermore, we can improve the model by adding substances interaction, if necessary, even by modifying the model for this purpose, only if the calculation techniques adopted allow the problem to be solved. Thank you for your attention.